Hello guys and welcome back to Excelsior Academy. So in this lecture, we are going to talk about the titration of amino acids. Now, why titration is important? Because it is going to tell about the properties of amino acid, like how they are going to behave in presence of acidic pH, yeah, basic pH or yeah, neutral ho. So overall also the protein, how it is going to behave, ye sab hume kaise pata chala hai? Titration study se ye sab pata chala hai, theek hai? Okay. Now, one second. Okay. So, in the amino acids, there is always a two ionizable groups. So, what are those? NH3 plus and COO minus, right? Aise nahi bolna chahiye actually. NH2 bolna chahiye aur COOH bolna chahiye. Theek hai? Now, the ionic forms of amino acid depends upon the pH. Of course, because acidic pH mein kya hoga? You have got H plus jada. Right? So, your COO minus will become COOH and NH2 will become NH3 plus. In the other way, either case, yani ki jab jada aapka pH hai, high pH hai, so what will happen? H plus is going to be less and OH minus jada rahega. So, that time you are going to have NH2 aisa hi rahega and COO minus bhi aapka aisa rahega. Okay? Aapka H kam hona chahiye. Okay. So, titration is a useful tool in determining the reactivity of amino acid side chains. So, this is what I was telling, that it is important to understand how these amino acids are going to behave. Now, when an amino acid is dissolved in water, it exists in solution as a dipolar ion or zwitterion. So, why we say zwitterion? Because it has got the two ionic form, that is NH3 plus or COO minus. So, whenever amino acid is having these two, NH3 plus and COO minus, it is called zwitterion or dipolar ion. Now, what is the charge of this zwitterion? It is zero. Why? Because NH3 plus hai, yahan pe COO minus hai. So, total charge is going to be zero. Okay? Now, a zwitterion can act as either an acid, yani ki proton donor. So, donor, yani ki NH3 plus se aapne H de diya. Or it can act as a proton acceptor. So, it can accept H in the COO minus. Theek hai? Bahut simple basic chemistry tha ye. Now, substances having this dual nature are amphoteric and are often called ampholytes. So, ampholytes ka just topic hai. This will study in detail also in the upcoming lectures. Like how they are important in running the SGS page as well as the there is something called 2D gel electrophoresis. So, usme kaise ye kaam karte hai, it is really very important. Yeah. A simple monocarboxylic amino acid such as alanine. See, यहाँ पे क्या बोला है? Monoamine एक ग्रुप हो गया, monocarboxylic एक ग्रुप हो गया, ठीक है? So in this way, it is the amino acid such as alanine. But all amino acids you cannot call as monoamine and monocarboxylic group because जैसे glutamate हो गया आपका, वहाँ पे दो carboxylic group है, so वहाँ पे dicarboxylic आपको बोलना पड़ेगा, ठीक है? So जब भी question दिया जाता है, read carefully what they are saying. So, for example, amino acids like alanine, it is a diprotic acid when fully protonated. It has two groups, that is COOH and the NH3 group that can give H plus, yeah, proton. So, isliye hum isko kya bolenge? Diprotic, yani ki two hydrogen, two protons it can give. So, first one, of course, from the COOH it can give and second from the NH3 plus. So, yahan se do jagah se wo de sakta hai, theek hai? Okay. Now guys, this is also important. Ek bar figure dekhna yahan pe. Thoda dhyan do yahan pe. So what is the total charge over here? It is the plus. Yahan pe aapka COOH hai. Right? So hamesha yahan se pehle aapka H plus jayega. Always remember, sabse pehle H plus kahan se jayega? Which has got the lowest energy to release H plus. Theek hai? So pehle aapka yahan se jayega. Now second case mein yahan pe okay zero charge ho gaya hai. Now, second case, it is going from the NH3 plus. So, to overall, now here it is the minus one negative charge. Okay? This is in the case of the alanine. We'll see a few more other examples. Not all, but yeah, few more. Now, also, please remember, pH, it's for the proton concentration. So, every time we are going to talk pH with respect to proton concentration, many people get confused actually. Ek chota sa assignment mein deti hun yahan pe aap log ko. What does P stand in pH? P ka kya matlab hai? H is for the hydrogen concentration. So, P ka kya matlab hai? Second question, why the pH ranges from 1 to 14 only? ठीक है, असाइनमेंट क्लियर है? कल मैं नाम लेके किसी को भी पूछ सकती हूँ, ठीक है? So two assignments are, what does P stands in pH and why the pH has got only from 1 to 14 range only, 0 से लेके 100 तक क्यों नहीं है और 1000 तक क्यों नहीं है, why it is only till 14? Okay, this is your assignment. Search करके रखना, कल मैं पूछूंगी. Okay, now pKa, it is the equilibrium constant for the ionization. So we are going to talk about amino acids property with respect to pKa. So हम जब भी बात करेंगे pKa terms में बात करेंगे. So it is a measure of the tendency of a group to give up a proton. ठीक है, with that tendency decreasing tenfold as a pKa increases by one unit. So pKa increase हुआ तो इसका मतलब क्या, द टेंडेंसी टू गिव अ प्रोटॉन इज लेस. समझ में आ रहा है? pKa इंक्रीज हुआ, सो इट मींस द टेंडेंसी टू गिव अप अ प्रोटॉन इज लेस. ओके, बस इतना सा कोरिलेशन याद रखो, इजी हो जाएगा. ओके, नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक टाइट्रेशन कर्व्स व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक इन केस ऑफ ग्लाइसिन. ठीक है, सो यहाँ पे हो गया एसिड बेस टाइट्रेशन. Now this is the titration curve of the diprotic form of the glycine. So यहाँ पे first देखो 0 to 13 हमने दिया हुआ है, and look it over here. In the first case, so first pKa1 आपका 2.34 pH में हो गया है. So what does it mean? It has lost the proton from your COOH group. Remember we talked about this. So पहला H आपका कहां से जाएगा? COOH से जाएगा, ठीक है? And that happened over here 2.34 में. Second H आपका NH3+ से जाएगा, that is your pKa2. That happened at 9.6. Now if I need to calculate the pI of glycine, it is going to be the average of the two pKa values at which they have lost the proton. तो इसका average कितना हुआ? 2.34 plus 9.60 divided by 2, you are going to get 5.97. इतना क्लियर है गाइस सभी को ग्लाइसिन के केस में?
यस मैम.
हाँ, दिस इज सिंपल. ओके, आई विल गिव यू वन न्यूमेरिकल आल्सो एट द एंड ऑफ दिस लेक्चर, सो विद दैट इट विल बी क्लियर लाइक कितना आप कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर होता है ना. ठीक है, सो सेम स्टोरी इज गिवन ओवर हियर लाइक हाउ इट इज लूजिंग एंड हाउ इट इज बिकमिंग COO minus and then NH2 at what pKa value. So everything is given. So once I give you these notes, you can just go through. Okay, जो explain किया है वही सब यहाँ पे लिखा है अभी. Okay, now let's talk about the alanine. Now अभी अंतर क्या हुआ alanine and glycine में? कुछ ज्यादा अंतर हुआ क्या? नहीं, right? Because it doesn't have any other titratable groups. जो glycine में था वही आपका alanine में है. NH3+ से जाएगा और CO- से जाएगा. सो फर्स्ट आपका कहां से गया? COO- से गया, COOH से गया, एंड देन NH3+ से. सो अगेन हाउ मेनी ग्रुप्स आर देयर? टू आर देयर. ठीक है, सेम स्टोरी. एंड फाइनली व्हेन यू कैलकुलेट यू आर गोइंग टू गेट नियर अबाउट ग्लाइसिन. सो ग्लाइसिन में आपको कितना मिला था? 5.97, एंड इन द केस ऑफ एलानिन यू गॉट 6.02. नाउ व्हाई दिस डिफरेंस इज कमिंग, इवन दो इट इज द सेम प्रोसेस, व्हाई द डिफरेंस इज कमिंग? Anyone? So glycine, we saw that pI is 5.97. Now alanine, pI is 6.02. Even though in both the cases the ionizing group was starting from COOH and next it was NH3+, right? So pKa, pK1 यहाँ पे ये था and pK2 ये था. So guys, tell me why the difference is coming, even though it is hardly 0.05 difference is there. So why the difference is coming? Because? Any idea? Pallavi, what do you think? Kya ho sakta reason?
Because the pKa1 and pKa2 value are different.
Wo to hai hi, that's why average is different. That is it. That is mathematical difference. डिफरेंस क्यों आ रहा है? इवन दो इट इज फर्स्ट रिलीज फ्रॉम द कार्बोक्सिल ग्रुप एंड सेकंड इज रिलीज फ्रॉम द एमिनो ग्रुप, मेरे हिसाब से तो सेम होना चाहिए, बट स्टिल स्लाइट डिफरेंस यू कैन सी. द That slight difference is because of the structural properties, right? At the end, what we are dealing is the structure of the amino acids. So you know that in the case of glycine, you don't have R group, whereas in the case of alanine, you have what, the methyl group, right? So methyl group is what, aliphatic group. It is going to make a difference whenever you are actually removing the H plus. And because of this structural difference, this minor difference in the PI, you can see. Okay. So, but practically, if I give you a PI strip, एक स्ट्रिप आती है जिसमें डिफरेंट 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 इम्यूनो एसिड्स सॉरी डिफरेंट पीएच इज गिवन एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर इम्यूनो एसिड्स विल गेट प्रेसिपिटेटेड. सो पीआई मींस व्हाट, द चार्ज एट दैट पर्टिकुलर इम्यूनो एसिड और प्रोटीन इज गोइंग टू बी जीरो, दैट इज द पीआई ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर प्रोटीन. ठीक है, उस पर्टिकुलर पीएच में प्रोटीन के ऊपर चार्ज होगा वो जीरो होगा एंड इसलिए वो प्रेसिपिटेट कर जाएगा. तो अब क्या होगा, अगर मैंने ग्लाइसिन और अलानिन यूज किया, व्हाट विल हैपन, since they are PI is so nearby, both are going to be deposited in the same line. PI strip कैसा दिखता है, आपने PH strip देखा होगा ना, ऐसे color wise रहता है, 1 to 12 या 1 to 13 रहेगा. So in the same way, PI strip is also available. So if I run glycine and alanine, what will happen? They both are going to get deposited in the same region, just because they have got the nearby PI range. Okay? So from that, I cannot differentiate whether my sample was having glycine or alanine or mixture. Abhi clear hai thoda sa?
Yes, ma'am.
But if you have a protein which is having good number of glycine or alanine, then you can see the difference. Because even if it is minor difference, but if you have glycine 100 amino acid, but alanine 2 hi rahenge, so that difference can be seen. Overall total PI will change of the protein. Okay, just mathematical way. Okay, so this is how the curve is shown. This is in the case of alanine. Ye humne dekha hai abhi, 2.34 aaya hai, 9.69 aaya hai. So average is going to be average of these two. So 2.34 plus 9.69 divided by 2, you will get 6.02. Okay, now let's talk about the PI of amino acid with ionizable side chain. So kaun se ho gaye, जिसके पास एक्स्ट्रा कार्बोक्सी ग्रुप हो गया या एक्स्ट्रा एमिनो ग्रुप हो गया, फॉर एग्जाम्पल लाइसिन, राइट. नाउ वन मोर थिंग, इन पॉलीप्रोटिक एसिड द प्रोटॉन्स आर लॉस्ट फ्रॉम द ग्रुप विद द लोवेस्ट पीके. रिमेंबर मैंने क्या बोला था, जितना पीके हाई होगा उतना आपका टेंडेंसी टू लूज हाइड्रोजन कम रहेगा, जितना लो होगा उतना ईजी होगा. गेटिंग द पॉइंट? So lowest pKa is good to lose H plus. Simple bhasha mein. Okay. Now, so this is the PI of lysine. It is the average of the pKa values of the two groups that are positively charged in their acidic form and the uncharged in their basic form. So here it is given that pKa 1, ye jab aapka COOH se remove hota hai, H plus aapka. Okay. pKa 1 is always from the COOH group. Then pKa 2 is from the amino group. Okay, mention kiya yahan pe amino group ho gaya aapka ye. Theek hai? Now pKr, that is for the side chain. So how much it is? 10.79. And yahan pe 2.18, 8.95. Ab yahan pe teen value hai. And here when you talk about ionizing group ka PI, you cannot take the average of all the three values. Kiska average aapko lena padega? ग्रुप्स विच आर पॉजिटिवली चार्ज, ठीक है, यानी कि सेम चार्ज वाले ग्रुप को आपको लेना है साथ में. सो वो कौन से सेम चार्ज हो गए? सो लाइसिन हैज गॉट द एमिनो ग्रुप, सो यू आर गोइंग टू टेक 10.79 एंड यू आर गोइंग टू टेक 8.95 यहाँ पे एंड टेक द एवरेज, द यू आर गोइंग टू गेट इज द पीआई ऑफ दैट एमिनो एसिड. इतना क्लियर है कि कब अगर कोई तीन वाली है तो हमें कौन से दो वैल्यूज सेलेक्ट करनी है. ठीक है
मैम, कैन यू रिपीट दिस पार्ट वंस अगेन?
हाँ, ओके. सो व्हेनेवर वी हैव गॉट द आयोनाइजिंग ग्रुप, ओके, द लाइसिन, सो वी हैव गॉट द लाइसिन, वी हैव गॉट ग्लूटामेट हैविंग एक्स्ट्रा सीओएच ग्रुप राइट इन द साइड चेन. नाउ हाउ डू वी कैलकुलेट पीआई ऑफ सच अमीनो एसिड? सो दिस इज एग्जांपल ऑफ लाइसिन. सो फर्स्ट पीके 1 ऑलवेज फॉर ऑल अमीनो एसिड इज दी सी ओ एच, यानी कि जहां से सबसे पहले आपका एच प्लस रिमूव होगा. सेकेंड हमेशा आपका एमिनो ग्रुप से होगा, करेक्ट. सो दिस इज योर पीके 1, पीके 2. Now, third one is always from the side chain. Okay, so the kya value diya hua hai 2.18, 8.95, 10.79. Now, in such cases where you have got three pk values, you cannot take the average of all the three. कहने को हम क्या कर सकते थे, आई वुड हैव एडेड ऑल द थ्री एंड डिवाइडेड बाय थ्री करती, मुझे पीआई मिल जाता, बट दिस इज नॉट करेक्ट. ओके, व्हाट इज द करेक्ट आंसर इज यू नीड टू टेक द ग्रुप्स विच आर ऑफ द सेम चार्ज. सो लाइसिन के केस में क्या है, इट इज द पॉजिटिव चार्ज, द ग्रुप्स दैट आर पॉजिटिवली चार्ज. सो व्हाट आर दोज ग्रुप्स, एमिनो ग्रुप उसका साइड चेन हो गया और यहाँ पे एमिनो ग्रुप हो गया. सो आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द एवरेज ऑफ द सेम चार्ज दैट इज पॉजिटिवली चार्ज. So that is 8.95 यहाँ पे and 10.79. I'll take the average of these and I get my PI as 9.87. अभी clear है?
Yes ma'am.
You are going to take the average of the same charge. अब ये हो गया lysine, इसलिए हमने positive charge बोला. Let's take another example of the glutamate. So glutamate has got what? COOH, correct? So in this case, what I'm gonna do? In this case, I'm going to take different. So I have got my PK1, that is from the COOH. This is from amino group. Now side chain ka diya hua hai. Now side chain mera glutamate mein kya hai? Again another COOH. Now in this case, it is going to be the negatively charged. Correct? Once it loses the H plus. What I'm going to do? I'm going to take the average of these two. So 2.19 and 4.25 ka average I get as 3.22. Theek hai? Abhi clear hai?
Ultimately, the PI is going to be an indicator of
where the amino acid is going to be having zero charge.
Okay, ma'am. Yeah, zero charge. Huh?
Zero charge. Net charge at that particular PI is nothing but a pH at which amino acid is having zero charge.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, pH at which the net charge is zero. Ab ye to amino acid ka ho gaya. Aage we are going to talk about the protein. And we know that proteins are made up of hundreds and thousands of amino acids. Overall charge kitna hoga, that we are going to study. And that is what is going to determine whether your protein is going to have what kind of interactions. So we have already talked about non-covalent interactions, right? So depending on the charges of the protein, we will understand what kind of interactions they are going to make. And that's how you understand kaisa function karega with the substrate or with the ligand. Okay? So this is the total chart of the PK1, PK2 and the side chain ka. No need to remember. Jaha dash, it means what? It does not have a side group which is having the ionizable group. Okay? Yani ki H plus release nahi hota hai wahan se. For example, serine. Serine has got OH. So OH में से H plus आपका रिलीज नहीं होगा. It does not have ionizing group. ठीक है, that's why there is a dash. Okay, so I'm gonna give you one question now. अपना book paper निकाल लो. Okay, so there are three values given. One second. Okay. So there is an amino acid. Let me share the okay, I have a blank screen. Okay. So I'll write it over here, your question. So your question is, there's an amino acid which has got three ionizable group. Okay. With pK values as pK1 is 2.0, pK2 is 10.5, and pK3 is 3.8. What is the pI of this amino acid? Calculate PI. Now, you need to use your presence of mind, because here एमिनो एसिड इज पॉजिटिवली चार्ज और नेगेटिवली चार्ज ऐसा कुछ नहीं बोला. इट जस्ट मेंशन दैट इट हैज गॉट थ्री आयोनाइजेबल ग्रुप. सो नाउ गाइज यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट द पीआई. सो कैसे होगा? क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन?
यस मैम.
ओके सो टेक योर टाइम. आई मीन इतना भी मत लेना. But at least tell me how you are going to proceed.
Six point four five.
कितना?
6.45.
No. इतना तो नहीं आएगा. कैसे क्या रहने?
मैम 2.0 और 3.8 का एवरेज ले लिया.
तो उसका एवरेज कितना आएगा? 6?
नहीं, अप्रोक्स 2 और 10.5 दोनों का ऐड कर दिया, फिर उसके बाद 2 से डिवाइड कर दिया.
अरे जब तुमने 2 और 3 का एवरेज लिया तो फिर इसको क्यों एवरेज लिया? एवरेज एक ही बार लेना है ना. ओके व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स? रंजन थोड़ा सा सही है, फिर से दोबारा करो. ओके व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स? स्मृति सॉल्व किया, कितना आ रहा है?
मैम मैंने भी सेम ही किया है, मुझे आंसर 2.9 आ रहा है. आई एम नॉट श्योर.
2.9 मतलब इसका हाफ, राइट? दैट इज 2.9 है ना?
हाँ मैम.
हाँ सो
आई कंसीडर दोस टू.
ओके बट व्हाई यू हैव टेकन PK1 एंड PK3? PK1 PK2 क्यों नहीं लिया? PK2 PK3 क्यों नहीं लिया? सो आंसर इज करेक्ट. सो द आंसर इज करेक्ट. Your answer should be PI is 2.9. Very good. जैसे भी किया, good. MCQs में हमें answer ही चाहिए होते हैं. But right now, I want to know why you have taken PK1 and PK3. Smriti, क्या reason है? Pallavi, what do you think? What will be the answer or the reason behind this? See, galat honne to kuch nahi hota, koi problem nahi. It's very simple. See, koi bhi three ionizable group hai.
Ma'am, the difference between 3.8 and. So the difference between 3.8 and 10.5 is very much. So
yes.
It indicates that it requires more energy. So that may be the same group and that is the another group.
Okay. I mean, let me say, I hope you understood the same. Like, let me also say once again. See, कैसा हुआ है? The logic what you use is correct. ठीक है? 2.0 and 3.8. They are nearby. It means what? They are supposed to be having the same group because the loss of electron, because their pK values are nearby. So the tendency to lose H plus is easy for them as compared to 10.5. 10.5 matlab kya? pKa high means losing H plus is difficult. So it means it is going to be a different group as compared to pK1 and pK3. यही लॉजिक था पल्लवी?
यस मैम.
हाँ सी, कुछ भी नंबर होता, अगर सपोज यहाँ पे 10.5 होता, हाँ, तो देन वी वुड हैव सेड दैट PK2 एंड PK3 आर बिलोंगिंग टू द सेम कैटेगरी आयनाइजेबल ग्रुप एज कंपेयर टू द PK1, बिकॉज द डिस्टेंस, द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज इज ह्यूज एंड दैट इंडिकेट्स दैट दिस इज टोटली डिफरेंट ग्रुप एंड द टेंडेंसी टू लूज एच प्लस इज high over there as compared to yahan pe PK1 and PK3, and that's why even though they have not mentioned that it is negatively charged or positively charged, still you are able to calculate the PI. So aapko kya karna hai? Nearby PK values ka hamesha average lena hai. Abhi clear hai?
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Okay guys, chalo I'll stop now. Do you guys have energy for the another lecture?